1 hour or so, I published a circuit with which you can test PNP and NPN transistors, and then especially the idea of matching. Say, match a NPN transistor to a PNP transistor, or perhaps even matching, say, a bunch of NPN transistors and or a bunch of PNP transistors. I made a video, but I made one big mistake. Well, tried to say correct that in the text box, but this is, say, the warning circuit. My earlier video was very okay, but I only forgot here to show that the red LED gives an indication about the supply voltage, and that supply voltage here is very critical. Anyway, here is again the same name of that video, matching transistor tester, say transistor tester with which you can match and test transistors. It's 11 November 2024. Well, the first question in that earlier video of today was, does it make sense? Does it make sense to match transistors? Well, there are two answers to that question. Yes, it makes sense, but on the other hand, sometimes it does not make sense. And the reason is that when you have, say, such an audio amplifier with an NPN transistor and a PNP transistor, the properties don't have to be completely the same. Because here, in general, we have a voltage drop, and it means that there is a quiescent current flowing here. And there's also another part of that circuit that prevents crossover distortion. Well, so that was the first things that I told in that earlier video that is now removed from YouTube. Anyway, what say the idea of this tester? Here is the tester again. Here we can set the base current here, and I'm testing now a 2N3055 NPN transistor, and when we move the potentiometer here, where we give the transistor here a higher base current, the collector current will also raise here. You can see it here. I'm now turning that potentiometer, and we are on 24 volts. Anyway, of course, I made a big disclaimer in this video, and the reason is that when you don't set the switches to the right position, you can disturb, not only disturb, but only, not only, but damage your transistor under test. I've made a triple switch for power transistors, medium power transistors, small signal transistors, and when you know a little bit about electronics, that only refers to the base current. So a small signal transistor needs, in general, say a base current in the order of 30 microampere, and a power transistor needs a base current to work properly in the order of 1000 microampere. Say that's 1 milliampere. And that's what I'm doing here, changing the base current. And here there is a switch showing that we are talking about an NPN or a PNP transistor, and I want to refer to the earlier video on my YouTube channel where I have, say, explained that I needed a certain circuit working between 6 volts and 60 volts to, say, indicate NPN or PNP. I'm not going to switch now between NPN and PNP because it can damage the transistor. Anyway, here is, say, a kind of node in between, and well, let me show the schematic. That's perhaps very interesting. Here is the schematic. And here you can see directly, say, the reverse switch here, positive to negative. The switch with which we can reverse the base current and the collector current, that's of course very important. With these three resistors, I have tried to, say, get the base current under certain control. Here it is 1 M2, 135 kilo ohm and 18 kilo ohm for the power transistor, medium power transistor. It is, say, approximately 100 kilo ohm, and here it is, say, approximately 1 mega ohm. And here's a node via which you can test and set the base current. Of course you cannot, say, set it, but when you open that switch here, take the parts apart and connect here a microampere meter, then you are absolutely sure how the relation is between the base current in the microampere range and the collector current. That's visible here in the milliampere range, and that milliampere range goes from, say, 0 milliampere to approximately 400 milliampere or so. It is more or less related to the transistor that you have under test. The warning circuit is here. It is here again. I have forgotten to show the LED, the light emitting diode, in the earlier video, so I want to do it all over again because I don't want to publish circuits on YouTube that are not reproducible or so. Anyway, this is, say, the overview. And when you are a little bit acquainted with electronics, you will surely see how this works. The NPN transistor is tested, or the PNP transistor is tested. Here is a reverse switch to the circuit, and here is the 100 microampere meter, that's here. And here is the way to give different values to the base current. Anyway, transistor on the test is here. I've tested this part of the circuit, 1 mega ohm, 235 kilo ohm, 18 kilo ohms, and here are the base currents at 40 volts. A small signal transistor, 30 microampere. For a medium power transistor, 250 microampere. And for a power transistor, 2 milliampere. And well, most important thing is here that I have to make a serious disclaimer. When you don't set the positions of the switches right, your transistor under test can burn out here. When you switch the transistors during the test from NPN to PNP or reversed, also the transistor can burn out. And well, the warning circuit also has here a BD139, and that BD139 will get very, very hot because it must act between voltages between 6 and 40 volts. So anyway, that's the reason why I've made here a heatsink and some mesh. The reason is that for serious transistor tests and matching certain transistors, it could be that you need a high voltage, and of course, more or less of course, there is perhaps no linearity between the base current and the collector current related to certain supply voltages. And now I'm supplying it with 23 volts. I've done quite a few tests before publishing this circuit, and I found that sometimes, not always, there is no linearity or a smaller linearity between the base current and the collector current when we lift up that collector current by using this potentiometer. Anyway, thanks for watching. The circuit is in a certain way very universal, usable. You can test thermal runaway, the current amplification, test whether it is a high voltage transistor or not, match transistors, NPN and PNP, etc. Endurance testing during days, save test voltages, get an ID about power or medium power transistors, etc. It works only with BGT transistors. Well, I hope this compensates in a certain way my earlier video that was removed. I have removed it, by the way, on YouTube because there was no red LED here. Anyway, thanks for watching. I will surely make a second video about this test circuit. And at the moment I'm testing a 2 and 3 over 5. Thanks for watching.